Good evening, viewers. I am Sanjay Sharma, Senior Manager Services in GSTF, and I welcome you all to yet another webinar being hosted by GSTF on removing difficulties in filing of annual returns. So, the topics that we are going to cover in the webinar today, the first part would relate to answering issues which relate to filing of annual returns in form GSTR 9, 9A, and the consolidated summary which is to be submitted in form 9C. The other part would relate to the technical problems which have been reported and what is the status of their resolution. So we'll go through them one by one. One of the questions that we received was that I have availed ITC in the month of September 2017 in form GSTR 3B, but again, by mistake, I have availed it again in the month of October 2017. So that means he has claimed the ITC twice for the same inward supply. However, in this case, the taxpayer has reversed the same in form GSTR 3B in the month of November 2017. Now his question is, while filing form GSTR 9, how can he correct the same? And his other part of the question is whether table 6B is to be filled up for correction. So I would like to tell the viewers here that in table 6B of GSTR 9, one is required to enter ITC for inward supply only once. Now, since the table 8B of GSTR 9 is auto-populated from table 6B and 6H, no further action would be required from the taxpayer. But there is an alternative method where you can reverse the ITC by reporting it in GSTR 9 table 7 also. The second question is, I could not claim ITC for financial year 17-18 up to March 2019 in form GSTR 3B returns. Can I claim it in form GSTR 9 now? Well, I would like to tell the taxpayers that there is no provision to claim ITC through form GSTR 9 return at all. Form GSTR 9 is merely a consolidated statement of all the annual returns and also provides the taxpayer with an opportunity to discharge his pending tax liabilities. The third question is, ITC for goods or services received in the previous financial year could have been availed in the returns filed for the month of April to September of the current financial year or the date of filing annual returns for the previous financial year, whichever is earlier. Where should I declare ITC and whether table 4A of form GSTR 3B can be used for filling up these details? Well, the answer is yes, you can declare it in table 13 of form GSTR 9. You can also use table 4A of GSTR 3B for filing these details. ITC of 2017-18, if not claimed by due date of return of March 2019, which mind you was extended from September 18 to March 19 by the government, cannot be claimed thereafter. But please remember to include ITC in Form 3B before filing annual return in GSTR 9. The next question is, if I have overvalued my sales for the financial year 17-18 and amended these values in financial year 18-19, where can I enter this information in Form GSTR 9? Well, you can enter this information in table 11 of form GSTR 9. The next question is, what is the meaning of separately declaring inputs, output services, and capital goods in table 6 of form GSTR 9? The taxpayer is required to segregate the ITC availed under following heads, depending upon the use of such inputs, goods, or services. One is the ITC on inputs. The other one is the ITC on capital goods, and the third is ITC on services. So the taxpayer is required to enter each type in table 6 of GSTR 9 separately. Next question is, how should a taxpayer calculate interest amount while making entry in table 14 of form GSTR 9? So the answer is, as per section 50 of the GST law, the taxpayer is required to calculate interest separately under each act, that is IGST, CGST, SGST, and Compensation Cess Act. But he has to enter the consolidated amount in Table 14 of Form GSTN 9. The next question is, in GSTN 9 for inward and outward, is HSN-Y summary mandatory or not? And what is the limit on turnover for such declaration? The answer is, in Table 17, which relates to outward supplies, for turnover up to Rs. 1.5 crore, HSN-Y summary is optional. For turnover between Rs. 1.5 crore to 5 crore, two-digit HSN summary is mandatory. For turnover over Rs. 5 crores, four-digit HSN summary is mandatory. So as per the existing instructions, HSN-Y summary details in Table 18, which relate to inward supplies, accounting for 10% of or more independently in value terms, is also required to be furnished. The next question is, can a taxpayer edit details in Form GSTR 9 after clicking on compute liability? The short answer is, any time before filing of the Form GSTR 9, the taxpayer is free to edit any details. The next question is, in GSTR 9, data of GSTR 2A is not reflecting correctly. It is showing less data as compared to GSTR 2A. Why? Well, I must tell you that the data from Form GSTR 2A is auto-populated into GSTR 9 on a periodical basis. The last such auto-population was done on 1st of May 2019. So there can be a time lag sometimes between the auto-population from 2A to GSTR 9. That could be one possible reason. The other reason could be the ITC applicable on inward supplies received on account of import of goods, import of services, tax paid on reverse charge mechanism basis is not reflected in Form GSTR 2A. However, the taxpayer is entitled to avail ITC on these. Accordingly, he is advised to calculate these manually and enter these details in Form GSTR 9. At times, the difference between these two values can also occur on account of place of supply issues. So it can so happen that an interstate supply has been mistakenly shown as intrastate supply. So the total amount of ITC, while remaining constant, it may appear in two different parts. So that could be one more reason. But the thumb rule is that the taxpayer is required to enter the actual data based on his or her books of accounts or returns filed during the financial year. The next question is, how to treat ITC if I have claimed in Form GSTR 3B, but supplier did not submit it in Form GSTR 1, and it's not reflecting in Form GSTR 2A and Form GSTR 9 data? Well, it's a question which has been asked constantly by different taxpayers on different fora in different words, but then essentially the essence is the same. I would like to tell you that Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs has already clarified the matter in one of their press releases, and I will quote verbatim from that. It says, it may be noted that auto-population is a functionality provided to taxpayers for facilitation purposes. Taxpayers shall report the data as per their books of account or returns filed during the financial year. But ultimately, the ITC claimed will have to be settled by the tax authorities as per the provisions of Section 16, 17, and 18 of the GST law. The next question is, exempted and non-GST inward supplies option is not available in Form GSTR 9 or 9A. I must tell you, there is no requirement to declare the inward supplies relating to exempted and non-GST supplies in Form GSTR 9 or 9A. However, if the total inward supply exceeds 10% of the value, HSN-Y summary is to be provided in Table 18 of GSTR 9. The next question is, the taxpayer is unable to see tabs of annual return in Form GSTR 9 or GSTR 9A. What could be the possible reasons? So the answer is, the tabs for Form GSTR 9 or 9A are only enabled on the portal if the taxpayer has already filed Form GSTR 1 and Form GSTR 3B or Form GSTR 4, if applicable, for all the months of the relevant financial year. and there is no other reason for these tabs to be not to be enabled. So there are a few important points which were clarified by the CBIC in their press release on annual returns. I would like to quote the press release here, and I'll quote verbatim from whatever has been released by the CBIC in this case. It says, the last date of filing of annual return in form GSTR-9 is 30th June 2019. In effect, the date has been extended. The information contained in form GSTR-2A as on 1-5-2019 shall be auto-populated in Table 8A of form GSTR-9. The input tax credit on inward supplies shall be declared from April 2018 to March 2019 in Table 8C of form GSTR-9. Particulars of the transactions for the financial years 2017-18 declared in returns between April 2018 to March 2019 shall be declared in Part 5, which contains Table 10 to Table 13 of form GSTR-9. Such particulars may contain details of amendments furnished in Table 10 and Table 11 of Form GSTR-1. It may be noted that irrespective of when the supply was declared in Form GSTR-1, the principle of declaring a supply in Part 2, which relates to Table 4, or Part 5, which is essentially Table 10, is essentially driven by when the tax paid through Form GSTR-3B in respect of such supplies. If the tax on such supply was paid through form GSTR-3B between July 2017 to March 2018, then such supply shall be declared in Part 2. And if the tax was paid through form GSTR-3B between April 2018 to March 2019, then such supply shall be declared in Part 5 of form GSTR-9. Any additional outward supply which was not declared by the registered person in Form GSTR-1 and Form GSTR-3B shall be declared in Part 2, that is Table 4 of the Form GSTR-9. Such additional liability shall be computed in Part 5, that is Table 9, and the gap between the tax payable and paid through cash column of Form GSTR-9 shall be paid through Form DRC-03. The CBIC press release, the last point on that is, many taxpayers have reported a mismatch between auto-populated data and the actual entry in their books of accounts or returns. One common challenge reported by taxpayer is in Table 4 of Form GSTR-9, where details may have been missed in Form GSTR-1, but tax was already paid in Form GSTR-3B, and therefore taxpayers see a mismatch between auto-populated data and data in Form GSTR-3B. It may be noted that auto-population is a functionality provided to taxpayers for facilitation purposes, and taxpayers shall report the data as per their books of accounts or returns filed during the financial year. I'm sorry, the last point comes now. Many taxpayers have represented that Table 8 has no row to fill in credit of IGST paid at the time of import of goods, but availed in the return of March 2018 to March 2019. Due to this, there are apprehensions that credit which was availed between April 2018 to March 2019, but not reported in the annual return may lapse. For this particular entry, the taxpayers are advised to fill in their entire credit availed on import of goods from July 2017 to March 2019 in Table 6E of Form GSTR-9 itself. Okay, I'm again sorry, the last point comes up now. The payments made through Form DRC-3 for any supplies relating to period between July 2017 to March 2018 will not be accounted for in Form GSTR-9, but shall be reported during reconciliation in Form GSTR-9C. So with this, we come to the end of the press release of CBIC. We have also been reported certain issues on filing of Form GSTR-9C. So I'll briefly touch those points. One of the queries was the turnover of rupees 2 crore is to be calculated from 1-4-2017 or it is to be calculated from 1-7-2017. Well, I must tell the viewers that turnover of rupees 2 crore will be counted for the period 1/4/2017 to 31/3/2018. As per the details furnished in Table 5G of Form GSTR 9C, turnover from 1/4/2017 to 30/June/2017 will be deducted from the total turnover. So one of the questions was, if I have a nil turnover reported in Form GSTR 9, do I need to file Form GSTR 9C? Well, the short answer is no. The Form GSTR 9C is required to be filed by only those taxpayers whose turnover exceeds rupees 2 crore in a financial year. Now, some of the issues which are reported for filing of Form GSTR 9A are being touched upon in this section. Under which table exempt or nil rated invert supplies and supply received from unregistered dealer received after 13/10/2017, that is the date on which the RCM on purchases from unregistered persons was suspended under section 9(4) of the GST law, are to be reported. I must tell the taxpayers, there is no provision to file exempted invert supplies as well as invert supplies from unregistered persons received after 31/10/2017 in the Form GSTR 9A. The other question is whether we have to enter purchase details or whether we have to accept whatever the portal shows as purchase details. I must tell the taxpayers, the portal does not provide or display any such details. In the Form GSTR 9A, the purchase details are to be entered by the taxpayer himself or herself. The next question is it mandatory to declare purchase details in Form GSTR 9A? Well, yes, the purchase details are mandatory in case of invert supplies liable to RCM received from unregistered and unregistered persons in Table 7A and 7B respectively. Invert supplies from registered persons other than those liable to RCM in Table 8A. The taxpayer can utilize information furnished in Table 4A, 4B, 4C, 5 and 8A of Form GSTR 4 for providing these details. In continuation of the previous question, the next question was, can one declare invert supply on which RCM payable is negative? Well, the answer is, in Form GSTR 9A, details of invert supplies on which tax is payable on RCM basis, net of debit credit notes are to be provided in Table 7. The next question is, after due date, what is the late fee for filing of annual return? So the late fee for filing late filing of Form GSTR 9 and Form GSTR 9A is rupees 100 under the SGST Act and again rupees 100 under the CGST Act per day, subject to a maximum of amount calculated at a quarter percentile of the turnover in the state or union territory. In effect, if a taxpayer is only filing late for Form GSTR 9, he would be required to pay 200 rupees per day. In case he or she is required to file both GSTR 9 and 9A, he or she will be required to pay at least, he will be required to pay 400 rupees per day. It may please be noted that there is no late fee payable on nil annual returns. The next question is, while filing GSTR 9 and 9A, the portal is not accepting zero turnover if the taxpayer did not do any business in the financial year 2017-18. So when you go onto the portal and you navigate and to file your return, you are asked whether you are required to, whether you want to file nil return. If you choose nil return and select option yes, you will not be required to enter zero turnover anywhere. It may also please be noted that nil annual return can be filed by you for a particular financial year only and only if you have not made any outward supply, commonly known as sale, not received any goods or services, commonly known as purchases. You have no other liability to report. You have not claimed any credit. You have not claimed any refund. You have not received any order creating demand, and there is no late fee to be paid by you. So there were certain technical issues which were reported, and I'll just briefly touch upon them. While filing GSTR-9, the DSC and the EVC filing tab is disabled. How do I proceed further? Well, first you have to complete data entry in table 4 to table 18 of the form GSTR-9. Then click on the compute liability button. After this, the proceed to file button will be activated. Now, first you have to pay the late fee, if payable, that is. And after that, you can file using either the DSC or the EVC. The next question, to file GSTR-9 annual return, status shows ready to file, but proceed to file tab is not enabled to the end user. How to proceed further in this case? Now, in this case, please note that a late fee is payable by the taxpayer if the filing of return happens after the due date. So after clicking on compute liability button and paying the late fee only, the proceed to file tab will be enabled. Now, some of the issues which were reported by the taxpayers have been resolved. So just to save on time, I have compiled all these issues here, and I'll just read out to them these to you. These have been resolved already. So one of the issues which was reported, which has been resolved, is while filing the GSTR-9, the user was getting the error to file your annual return. Filing of all applicable returns, oblique statements, GSTR 1, 3B and 4 are mandatory. Please file your application return statements and try again, even though the returns had already been filed. The second issue which was resolved was the taxpayers was not able to file GSTR 9 after clicking on compute liabilities, and the system was returning an error RET00009. This has been fixed. GSTR 9 and 9A are not highlighted for the taxpayer who were in both composition and regular schemes in financial year 2017. Well, this issue has also been resolved. The other issue which was resolved was save request is under process for GSTR 9. Unable to save two-digit HSN code in GSTR 9. While end users are filing GSTR 9, they are getting message error GSTN exec 1003. This has been resolved. So while end users are trying to submit GSTR 9 or 9A, it is not getting open. They receive an error message saying system computed summary is in progress. This issue has been fixed. The other issue which was reported, which was fixed, was while filling GSTR 9 and 9A data, the data is not reflecting correctly, on which the tax has been paid. The other issue, while clicking on proceed to file button to file GSTR 9, system is prompting an error, return already under process. This also has been fixed. While selecting annual return GSTR 9 to file it, system is prompting an error. Annual return GSTR 9 is not getting open, profile gets auto logout. So all these issues have been sorted out. I must tell the viewers that they can connect with us on the Facebook. We have our exclusive YouTube channel also, and we have our Twitter handle, Ask GST Tech. So the taxpayers can connect with us on these, and they can also post their queries on these. We take care of answering all the queries here. So I hope this webinar has been useful and some of the issues that have been reported are solved. At the end, I would like to thank COGSTN, the entire services team, the technical team, and the other supporting team, NEGD, for all the support that they have provided in hosting this webinar. We have more than 125 webinars on our own YouTube channel, so you can go through them and hopefully they will be able to answer a lot of your queries. Thank you. Jai Hind.